You've all heard the term mystical force, but what exactly does it mean? All beings radiate a life force, but some have an additional mystical force, be it magical essence, demonic aura, or spiritual powers. So what exactly does this mean? The term mystical force is used to describe the special powers that characters within the series have. Mystical forces are divided into three main categories: magical essence, demonic aura, and spiritual powers. Though on the surface these powers seem identical and indistinguishable, there are subtle differences between them. Magical essence is the generic term for beings with magic powers called mages, regardless of what type of magic it is. The characters of Mystic and Noonien are two examples of characters with magical essence as their mystical force. Magic powers may be hereditary, natural to the species and or race, or from other artificial means, such as magic potions, objects, and so on. Depending on the exact nature of the powers, it may be necessary to recite incantations to engage specific spells. However, if one is powerful enough in their magic skills, they need only to think of the desired effect to make it happen, such as Mystic or Noonien simply casting a spell with a wave of their hand rather than performing an elaborate ritual or even saying a specific magic phrase for different actions to be taken. Demonic aura is the generic term used to describe the powers demons have. Demonic aura, like magical essence, can be natural to the race or species, but is also hereditary and is passed down from one or more of the parents. Thus, a human with a demon for an ancestor can inherit demonic aura via being passed down through the generations, though in that case their demonic aura is generally weaker and may not even be noticeable. An individual may not even be aware that they have it. Unlike magic, the powers of demonic aura are less direct. Demons generally use their powers to enhance their abilities, strength, speed, stamina, healing, and so on. In some cases, it may allow the user to change their appearance and/or form, gaining claws, wings, and such. Any other powers or abilities their demonic aura gives them are more general in nature, and unlike magical essence, they don't require spells or incantations to work. Tokujin is an example of a character with demonic aura as his mystical force. Despite the name, individuals with demonic aura don't get their powers from the devil, as the Order of the Cross claims. It would be more accurate to describe their abilities as natural traits of their race and species. Demons are simply another species living on Earth. Despite their appearance and abilities, they're not much different from humans. Like humans, some are kind and compassionate, some are malevolent and hostile, and most simply want to live normal lives. It is simple prejudice for being different from humans that makes people fear and hate them. Spiritual powers is the generic term used to describe the third main type of mystical force. Characters like Shiria, Sister Rose, and the other members of the Order of the Cross are examples of characters with spiritual powers as their mystical force. Spiritual powers are more vague than the other two, and are the most difficult to achieve. Unlike magical essence or demonic aura, spiritual powers take years of training and discipline to master. Most people who have these powers usually have strong spiritual or religious beliefs. They also tend to be monks or nuns, though this isn't necessarily a requirement. And they tend to live simplistic, non-materialistic lives in order to strengthen their spiritual beliefs and powers. Like demonic aura, spiritual powers are used to enhance one's abilities, strength, speed, stamina, and healing, as well as providing a form of ESP, such as visions of the future, a warning or feeling of danger, and so on. Some, like Shiria, believe that these powers lie dormant in everyone, and with proper training and practice, anyone can learn to harness these powers. Others, like the Order of the Cross, believe this power only appears to certain people chosen by God, and by extension, those who aren't chosen by God, who have similar powers, must have gotten them from the devil. While spiritual powers are developed through training, the time it takes one to develop such powers and their skill level may vary based on the individual. Some have to train long and hard to master spiritual powers, while others are just naturally gifted. It should also be noted that these three categories are not mutually exclusive. For example, if a mage and a demon were to conceive a child, then that child could theoretically have both magical essence and demonic aura.